So if you know anything about baseball, you know that it's not just a game of inches, it's also a game of numbers and statistics. For over 100 years now, we've been calculating things that happen on the field and recording them so that people can find out later on what happened to those in those games. We've been able to use those numbers to compare the quality of one pitcher versus another, one batter versus another, one team versus another. So we calculate things like earned run average, runs batted in, number of walks a pitcher gives, how many bases are stolen by a batter. All these statistics are used to know something about these players. We use those numbers to predict which team will win, which batter will be more successful against a different pitcher, and so on. These statistics are used to help us understand the game better. One of the interesting baseball statistics stories happened in 2002. For years, people have calculated the quality of batters by looking at how many runs they batted in and how many home runs they hit. The Oakland A's general manager, Billy Beane, decided to look at other statistics like the slugging percentage and the percent of times people got on base. And so he calculated these statistics and, based on those numbers, chose players that he thought would be better for his team. And they were a huge success because of that. Billy Beane was using statistics to predict who would be a great baseball player for his team. One of the things you'll notice about our statistics is that they all have symbols, for example. So runs batted in is RBIs, and people left on bases LOB, and those kinds of pretty simple symbols. But sometimes the symbols are kind of obscure. For example, you may not know this, but a strikeout is recorded as a K. Now, it may seem kind of strange to you because you might think the strikeout should be S, but we've just, over the years, we've decided to say that a K means a strikeout. You'll see this a lot in statistics as well. Instead of spelling out the word mean, we'll use a symbol that means mean. So X bar, for example, will mean mean. Instead of saying add everything up, we'll use a Greek symbol called sigma. So don't be confused about the fact that we're using different symbols. We use them in baseball, and we're going to use them in statistics as well. It's just like learning another language.